You are not an ordinary person. We are the outshining of God's glory. Don't let any circumstance have enough power to bother you. The Father has nowhere to stay than inside you and cannot express himself unless through your body. So your body becomes his body. That is why the Bible says we are the body of Christ. Sound this. Say, I'm a doer of the word. I'm a world shaker. I live by the word. I'm born by the word. We are here to produce heaven on this earth. I produce heaven on earth. Zadiva Kasi. For whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory. That's why I say, don't give up. Hey! Moko se kipara buka du se tibaha. Zagu. Rebege de bezia. Vege. Yakusa tifaros kipara kataya. Ah, I feel like turning water into wine.
Pastor Prince, we're hearing.
It's Atmosphere for Miracles, Dinomai, with Pastor Prince in the month of October 2021.
Spiritual authority. If you are born again, you are a Christian, and you do not understand spiritual authority, the devil will take advantage of you. He says, for we are not ignorant of the devices of the enemy. So there are devices of the enemy. But Paul said, we are not ignorant.
As the man of God declared over the room, he said, we are receiving a miracle right now. We are receiving a miracle right now. While in the room, on a Sunday evening.
At the same time,
I picked up my phone, and right on my phone, I received a notification of a transfer of money for the contract that I was working on over the last 2 months. Beloved, who are listening to us, these are unending device fables.
Yes, 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 yes.
We did not rehearse what we shared.
Yeah.
We are only sharing with you that which we have experienced.
It was a really disappointing moment. So Pastor Prince prayed for me, and I had a call on a Sunday evening from my supervisor's assistant, meaning that year I would be able to graduate.
Papa gave the word, and then the HR just came and said she wants to see me in the CEO's office. So when I went, he said she's going to put me on the same scale. So I'm now on the same scale with them.
Do you need the working of miracles in a specific area of your life? Register today and enter the faith line with Pastor Prince for a specific miracle in your life. You are blessed.
...2021 is our year of all grace.
Hey, glory! Hey.
Oh, I am, I give to you, Lord.
Oh, I
am,
I give to you, Lord.
Oh, I am, I give to you, Lord.
The true death, through the instrumentality of death. So the only way Jesus could have access to hell was to die, so that his spirit will enter hell, will descend to the deep and enter hell where the devil is. And the devil is known as the one who has the power of death. See, the power. See, when the scriptures talks about power, it's sometimes the English just says power. So he says, oh, it's power. But when he talks about power, he talks about somebody who has death under his control, who decides when to kill. Not as a thief cometh, but to steal, to kill. Why does he refer to him as a thief? Because of what he did in Genesis. The devil is a thief and a murderer. Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
He talks about somebody who has the control of death under his jurisdiction. Do you hear what I'm saying? Do you understand what I'm saying? For my action, you should know what I'm talking about. So he has all under his control. That is it. So he calls him the one who had the power of death, both spiritual and physical.
So when Jesus went there, he went there on behalf of all men. We are supposed to benefit from what he did because we have believed. Not all men have believed. So because they have not believed, the enemy has an advantage over them and has the legal right to touch them. You understand? And to block them from shining, and to block their activities, and to do this and to do that. He has that right because they have not believed in the Lord Jesus. But we who have believed in the Lord Jesus, we have a responsibility to appropriate what Jesus did. Or else we sit down for the enemy to just do what he wants to do. And I said the enemy is very structured. He's working to get many souls to hell. And we have to work. Say, I have to work. Say, I have to work. Very important. Destroy him that had the power of death. That is the devil. That is who? That is who?
The devil.
To render him impotent. To render him powerless. In the face of the Christian. Go to verse 15. Is that not powerful?
Powerful.
It says, and to deliver them who through fear of death were all their lifetime subject to bondage. Can I close? When you go home, just go and open the scripture and study it for yourself. Amen.
Amen.
Then come and tell me what you caught from it. Who will do that? Open it for yourself. Know the scriptures for yourself. Amen.
Amen.
Know these truths for yourself. That is one of the reasons why Jesus came. Or all his coming will be useless. We only say, oh, we belong to Jesus. Oh, we go to church. Oh, this is my denomination. Oh, my name is written in this book. Oh, and all that. But we wouldn't be able to appropriate these things in our lives. Jesus defeated the devil in his own territory and delivered them who were subject to bondage, their whole lifetime subject to bondage, delivered them so that they will be free. And was raised back to life and declared all hail. That means that I have come. Then there's all authority in heaven, on this earth, and in hell. This has been given unto me. Go therefore. So wherever you sit in that throne, you sit in the name of Jesus. It is not everything that is permitted to happen to you. One day I'll teach you about the name of Jesus. The name, the person that is holding that name has the authority over every name that is named in this world. It says, and the world to come. Not only in this world, but the world to come. Now think about it. If you are in that name, I say it every time, if Akufo-Addo gives you his name, all the ministries you can enter. Is that not true? He gives you his checkbook and gives you, he says, when you go, anything, just do, take anything, take it. I'm tired. Now it's, we're half rest then. I'm Akufo-Addo, but let me relax in my chair. Do all. Is that not true? Now think about it for 2 seconds. Sister Frida, are you there? So think about it small and see something. So when Jesus declared all authority is given unto me in heaven and on earth, when we believe in Jesus, I say we are in him, and we have that authority all over us, in us. So when we sit in a plane, or we sit in a car, or we sit in a bus, or we sit anywhere in our office, in the chair. That's why I said, when you say, oh, I sat in that chair, when I sat in that chair, they had done some juju. And the juju has now affected me. Now I've become paralyzed. I don't know what to do. My leg is doing like this. We should ask you a question. Because people who normally do that are people who run to church because juju has attacked their legs. True or false? After that juju that attacked their legs, is the OT law, is not there again. Is that not true? So they don't have that time to learn some of these things to prepare for those days where evil men are attacking. Did you hear what I said? Yes. If you say, when I sleep, I see demons. I see. You don't need to be prayed for here today. Today, you don't need to be prayed, even though you pray. Amen. Sit on the chair. When you go, just sit on the chair and take this scripture like this. and open just the NIV or the New Living Translation, a newer translation that you understand, and ask yourself whether it is true. From that day, all the witches and the demons and all of those days will leave you. True or false? Because it's for this purpose the Son of God was made manifest, that he might destroy, say destroy,
destroy,
the works of the devil, which includes spiritual death, the works of the enemy, and includes sin. So there is no such thing as, I've said it before and I'm saying it again, there's no such thing as a Christian say, oh, I'm struggling with this kind of sin. You are struggling with this kind of sin. It's because you say you are struggling. That's why you are struggling. Did you hear what I said? Because Jesus dealt with sin in the human spirit, so that sin does not have authority over any man. Then Jesus dealt with sin in the human body, in the flesh. Who heard what I said? Go to Romans chapter 8. Let me show you sin. I think some of you know sin in the human spirit. I've said it over and over. Is that not true? So let me give you sin in the flesh. So that your body, that you have, this, that's why I said, this body is the body of God. Did I say that? You can't carry your body, which is the body of God, and say it is struggling with sin. When I see this lady, my whole body begins to shake like this. I'm struggling. You don't need deliverance. It's not a family pattern. Amen. In our family pattern, we don't do that. That's why I say we have a royal family. It's your body pattern. You have not bound your body. You have loosed your body. True or false? Is that what? You are from Zion. What is there? There is therefore no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. Go to verse 2 quickly. Let me close with this one. Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
Who has heard something this morning? For the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death. Verse 3, quickly. For what the law of sin and death, he's talking about the law of Moses, what the law could not do in that it was weak through the flesh. So when the law was given, men could still not obey the law because there was still the reign of death. Jesus had not yet destroyed death, gone to hell, like I explained earlier. Amen. So because of that, those people who say, I want to do this thing, oh, but I can't do it. The way I don't want to, I want to stop this sin, but I can't stop this sin. My flesh is weak. Even the Bible says the flesh is weak. That was what they were saying. Amen.
Amen.
So it says, for what the law could not do, that it was weak through the flesh, God, come on, shout powerful. Read this scripture right now. When you read this scripture, if you are struggling with any kind of sin, amen. You are used to drinking to be drunken. And when you are coming, a whole world changer, when you are coming, they are holding your trousers to take you home. Come on, shout glory. Or when I sat in somebody's car, when the person is sitting in the car, is driving, the person is driving. Every lady, the person will see, the person will do like this.
Yay!
One time I said, hey, hey, hey. That problem is not a demonic problem. It means that you have let your flesh loose. Who heard what I said? Who heard what I said? And you see, that is why he talked about, for this cause, he that sins. We will go back to that scripture and I'll close with that one. But it's very important. Amen. The Bible says, the one who is born of God keepeth himself. He does what? So that he is not touched. So if, apart from, instead of preaching the gospel, you are preaching to ladies, you must change today. Is that true or false? We are all you, so let me address it here. You are preaching to all the ladies that come to this church. You can preach to them. Not the gospel. You are not part of outreach too. So we don't know who you are. We are reaching out to ladies.
Oh.
Come on, shout glory.
Pastor Prince will be right back.
Let your glory fill this house. Let your praises fill our mouth. Let each vessel offer up to you a sacrifice of praise.
Every delay that you have been experiencing in the name of Jesus is cancelled. I see the power of God. I see the power of God.
I just held where the bullets went, and I said, I am bulletproof.
They put my name in a national newspaper in Portugal.
So after Papa prayed for me, I got a response for one, and then they gave me the PhD scholarship. They will pay my tuition, which are about £17,000 sterling, a lot of money, and they were giving me stipend.
Experience the moments.
Welcome back.
You see, I've said it. I said there are different kinds of Christians, and this is very important. Is this very important? There are different kinds of Christians. Amen. There are carnal Christians. There are spiritual Christians. There are worldly Christians. When you live like that, you are a worldly Christian. You go to church. Your name is there. You might be part of the rapture. You might miss the rapture. Amen. 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 But you are worldly. And Satan is the god of the world as long as you are worldly. And that is the problem with many Christians. Yes, yes, yes. That's why we do deliverance. Deliverance, cast out devil. Deliverance, cast out devil. And we pray sometimes. I've said sometimes people say, my business is not working. Oh, my money is not working. And all that. We pray for you. We are praying for today. We say, bring your products, everything at point of contact. Let's pray. Is that not true? Yes, sir. The more we are praying that point of on that point of contact, the more you are also going after the flesh. And you are being worldly. So you are attracting demons in your life. That demon won't enter your spirit. Amen. Amen. The demon will just do like this. The business, you are going to sign the contract. When you go, the man say, oh, go, tomorrow morning. You say, Papa, pray that this contract will work. The demon that you have associated with through allowing the flesh is what is working. Demons are very constructive. Don't forget that. And very organized, very structured. Who heard what I said? So read it and then let me show you something. One, two, go. God sending his own son. In the likeness of sinful flesh. And for sin. Condemned. What is a condemned thing? What is a condemned thing? When we say your phone is condemned, what does it mean? It means you cannot use it again. Is that true? It means what? You cannot use it again. Now it says he condemned sin in the flesh. So Jesus did not just condemn sin in the human spirit, but he also condemned sin in the flesh. That's why your body now is the body of God, not the body of sin. Who heard what I said? So sin has, as far as God is concerned, sin has been condemned to render to destroy in the flesh. Did you hear what I said? So those feelings, you say, I have this, those feelings, I have, when I see a fair lady, I have these feelings. When I see a guy with hair, I have these feelings. When I see a thick, tall man, I have these feelings that come. They're like goosebumps. Read this scripture. Sin has been condemned. So you tell yourself, I refuse to serve sin in the flesh. My flesh does not serve sin. It serves righteousness. Did you hear what I said? This is so powerful. I wish I could take you to Romans chapter 6. But we will spend the whole day here. Amen. Amen. But he condemns sin in the flesh. Go to verse 4. Pastor Obed, do you like this one?
I love it.
He condemns sin in the flesh. That the righteousness of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not after the flesh, but after the spirit. So walking after the flesh is walking after yourself. You still have this feeling all of a sudden. If all that you feel is what you do, then you swallow poison. Is that not true? You say, Papa, it's not me. I just had the feeling and I couldn't control it. I had the edge. There is no such thing. It has been condemned. Speak to your body. Sin has been condemned in my body. I don't have edges for those kinds of things. I've been translated from death to life. Robert, did you hear that? Shout glory.
Glory.
Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
Who has heard something there? So the works of the devil has been destroyed. That's where I'll end with it. Shall we please be upstanding? Come on, shout glory.
We know you have been blessed by this message. We would like to invite you to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life by saying this prayer. Say, O Lord God, I believe with all my heart in Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. I believe he died for me and God raised him from the dead. I believe he is alive today. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is the Lord of my life from this day. Through him and in his name, I have eternal life. I am born again. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. I'm now a child of God. Congratulations, you are now a child of God. If you've said this prayer, kindly send a message or call the following numbers now showing on your screen.
Get more messages of Pastor Prince on our social media handles. Join us this and every Sunday at the World Changers Arena, Oswald House, Accra. You are blessed.